From a scientific perspective, there are two main models that are used to characterize frailty. One is referred to as the accumulated deficit model and was originally developed by Kenneth Rockwood. The other is referred to as the phenotype model, originally developed by Linda Freed. The accumulated deficit model is based on the Frailty Index. This index focuses on the number of identifiable deficits that an individual could have, selected from a list of possible deficits. The model doesn't prescribe what deficits should be looked at, but that as long as an appropriate list is developed, the number of identified deficits relative to the number of possible deficits is indicative of the frailty status of the individual. That means that the lower score of 0 is someone without deficits, so a robust person. The maximum score of 1 is when a person has all measured deficits. We will look into this in more detail in week 3, where we will explain how this model is used to identify frailty. The phenotype model focuses on 5 specific components. Unintentional weight loss reflects the status of the body in terms of energy intake and energy expenditure. The critical consideration here is unintentional, as losing weight because of a deliberate diet is not part of this criteria. Instead, it is concerned with people who typically reduce how much they eat and end up losing weight because of that, which can be considered a bad thing for older adults. A low energy expenditure, another component of the phenotype model, is centered around quantifying how much physical activity a person actually does, which includes walking, exercising, and sitting. Exhaustion reflects the ability to maintain your daily activities without feeling fatigued, so it's very much a subjective experience. That makes it different to a low energy expenditure, as it is not concerned with how much a person actually does, but how they experience this. Reduced muscle strength is related to the ability to perform daily activities, such as opening a lid or carrying the groceries. And the low grip strength can reflect possible difficulties with those activities. Finally, a low walking speed is another aspect of this frailty phenotype model. Compared to the accumulated deficit model, that specific approach of those 5 components is a very different approach. But each component has been suggested to reflect part of the aging process, as well as be related to daily functioning. It is often considered that the accumulated deficit model and the phenotype model are competitors, that you either belong on one side or the other. Our team probably somewhat favors the phenotype model. However, it is probably incorrect to put them down as competitors. The different approaches of the two models mean that they reflect different characteristics and have their own strengths and weaknesses. For example, it is not common clinical practice to record the characteristics of the phenotype model, and that makes it difficult to implement with existing clinical data. In contrast, with the accumulated deficit model, you can select the items of the list and therefore make sure it matches the existing clinical data. But the phenotype model is considered strong when it comes to screening currently healthy individuals, as the assessments really do focus on the functioning of the individual. And bad performance can be present in those who've never been to see the GP or other healthcare professional with this model. Plus, the phenotype characteristics are easier to recognize and probably easier to persuade people how they impact well-being, and therefore to increase the awareness of frailty in non-experts.